Hello, Leo. How are you? It's me, Lauren, with the Untitled Tarot. It's good to see you again. I have done your spread a little bit differently today. For one, we're upstairs. We're not being basement babies today. We're like the Jeffersons. We're moving on up. Second of all, I laid out your spread before your video, which is unlike me, but that's what they told me to do. So that is what I did. I have no further announcements. But your story is very interesting. Your cards were really like moving and shaking all over the place. I kind of laid them all out and they were saying one thing, and then I started moving them around and they gave another layer to the story, which I thought was very interesting. I would like to preface this reading by saying that your first five cards out are reversals. I don't want you to get nervous by that, okay? Because your spread ends really, really well. So don't get nervous. And I prepped my deck properly because when the first five came out, even I was a little nervous. I was like, oh no, maybe I didn't prep that deck right. But I did, and it all works out in the end. So just don't get nervous. If you, I think the whole theme of it is like being able to like turn things around, like turn our luck over. That's kind of the theme of your reading. So just don't get nervous when you see these first five cards, okay? I'm here for you. I'm with you. We're gonna get through it, I promise. So the first card you have out is you have the Hangman in reverse, right? And so normally the Hangman is about being a little bit of an indecision, crossroads, needing to make a decision. In reverse, it's making that decision, right? I'm looking at this card and I'm almost very drawn to this light and her reaching. Her reaching. It's like, what is she grabbing for? What is she grabbing for? What are you grabbing for, Leo? Next out, you have the Two of Cups in reverse, right? And then you have the King of Swords out in reverse. So originally, these first three cards pop out alone, and I'm like, okay, so I guess maybe they're making a decision about like cutting something out, maybe in like a cold or a cruel way, but like cutting out a relationship or like some kind of soulmate connection or like something that you once had a lot of love for. I was like, all right, let's keep pulling. So then the next two cards you had out was Five of Cups in reverse, right? And then you have the Seven of Cups in reverse. And I'm looking at this and that story just didn't feel right to me. I was like, that's not it. There's something else to this. And I started moving the cards around. And when I did that, things changed a little. So would you like to travel with me? Travel with me. We did this with Cancer too. Okay, so, oh, hold on. Everybody be cool. Okay, right, so Hangman here, right? Use Two of Cups. Flip it and reverse it, Missy Elliott style. For me, the way I look at this is it looks as though when this Hangman was upright, when you were in indecision, not really sure which way to go, which way to, you know, swing, perhaps you had these cups here, right? With this King of Swords, it looks like for me, like part of you is almost being dragged down by these spilled cups, and then part of you is trying to pull yourself up. And I know it's a Two of Cups in reverse, which is usually like a signifier of like a loss of love, but what I'm seeing is, see this hand? It's like your hand almost reaching up to try and grab this, to almost try and catch whatever remnants, like to almost. It's like when you go through a breakup or you move on to a new job or something, and you just try and take like the best out of that experience, all the life lessons that you could have learned, all the wisdom that you could, like just hold on to that good stuff. That's what it feels like. It feels like coming out of this Hangman, you know what you want. Like it's almost like you know that you want to take whatever is like the best out of this that you can. Take what you can really use, the things that will like unify you. Right? And not make you feel separate or indecisive, not separated, right? But as you're human, you know, this is like your higher self, and this is kind of like your lower self, almost like, because you see how this little vortex, it kind of goes almost right in to the cloth that she hangs from. So it almost feels like this pulling, like there's something like almost trying to pull you, this like victimhood, this like woe is me, just like being in your feelings about like spilt milk kind of thing. But in that release, in letting that go and reaching up for truly like the best out of these circumstances that you can, it's really, I feel like, helping you get Five of Cups in reverse, helping you get over that spilt milk, that disappointment, allowing you to be free enough, right? Let go of those cups, free enough to reach for the good out of that situation that you really can. Let's go back to where we were now. Hold, please. I'm old. Okay.
back to where we were.
All right. And so then I'm looking at the Seven of Cups up next. I'm like, Seven of Cups in reverse. Okay, so like not looking at options. And I pulled the card all the way back. And I'm very drawn to this blue. It's supposed to be like the ocean. But for me, it looks almost like I got like genie in a bottle, like trying to suck a genie back into a bottle, you know, like get it back in there. It's like Aladdin. It's almost like taking your wish back or making a new wish, like pulling back in your resources, grabbing just what you can out of your latest situations, experiences, relationships, and like kind of really thinking about it before you make a new wish. It's like pulling that genie back into the bottle. Like, oh no, bitch, I got two more. I'm going to use them real wisely this time. I'm going to use them real wisely. And then the next card you had out, put these back the way they were. I think it matters. Ace of Pentacles, baby. I was like, thank God in heaven when this came out. I was like, ooh, my Leo babies need this Ace of Pentacles so bad today. Holy shit. And next out, then you got the Hermit in reverse, right? Because you can't be in hiding. You can't start walking a Page of Pentacles path with your little ace if you're in the dark, if you're hiding, right? But then you got this Seven of Swords. I was like, ooh, they feel bad about it. I was like, why do you guys feel so bad? It's like, it seems like you went through something. You tried to take the best out of the experiences that you could. Pour the rest of the crap down the drain. Cut out some of your shit. I was like, and now you're being presented with exactly what you wanted, which is just like, this doesn't feel like a relationship necessarily, or like a job necessarily. It feels like just like a whole new start. Just like a whole new chance, like a whole new cycle change for you. Just like second shot, like a clean slate. It feels very much of like a clean slate. And getting ready to come out of this Hermit energy, right? You're out of this Hangman in reverse. You've made your decision. You've taken what you could out of the situation and you're ready to like start planting new seeds. But there's, for some reason, Leo, I feel like you feel bad about it. Like you feel really guilty about doing that. And I don't know why. We're gonna talk about it. And in particular, I'm being very drawn to this bird. Normally in this card, and this is like the sneaky, treachery, deceit, thief, sneaking away in the night card, right? I don't necessarily see it that way unless there's other cards around it that kind of, you know, back that up. But normally you're very much drawn to the actual character, the person in this card. I'm being very drawn to this crow. Screaming. It's the first thing I saw, and I heard it. I pulled this card, and when I looked at this bird, the first thing I heard was traitor. Traitor, traitor, traitor. It's like you're being granted the second chance, or just like a new opportunity to kind of start a clean slate for yourself, like having learned your lessons and obtained some kind of like maturity, you know, like a emotional intelligence, stability within yourself to kind of be able to like kind of plant new seeds and like finally getting ready. It's almost like getting out of the courage, like this ups in reverse. It feels almost like a very like a womb, like a little fetal energy, like you're just getting ready to like float up to the surface and like, you know, like birth your way up. It's like a little bud just getting ready to like boop, come out of the ground. And there are people around you maybe that are making you feel bad about that, that are making you feel like you're abandoning them, or you're being some kind of traitor, and it makes it feel like something that should be really like happy and refreshing and exciting for you. They're making you feel bad about it. They're making you feel like you're doing something wrong or sneaky. But I'm not getting a wrong or sneaky energy out of you. I'm not at all. And I would be, you know me, I'll tell you. I think you guys are on some shit, I'll tell you. But it's not. It feels like you learned your lessons, you ate your karma, and like you're ready to start again. And people are giving you a really hard time about it. And that makes me very defensive of my little Leo babies. And then next out, and I was like, and I asked, I was like, why does Leo feel like they're like being sneaky? Why, like, what, why is this happening? And then you got the Four of Pentacles out in reverse. And when this first flew out, I thought it was the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. And I was like, oh, that's interesting. I was like, something about this is really like upsetting like their sense of like stability and infrastructure, blah, blah, blah. And then I looked at it again and I realized it was the Four of Pentacles in reverse. And I was like, that's what they have to let go of. I was like, there's something in these crows for you. And then I'm drawn back to this Ace of Pentacles and all of the roots coming out of it in the hands, and I'm hearing bad seeds, bad seeds. It's like it's like you have to like let go of pots. It's like, you know, it's like this five of cups in reverse. You have to like pour some of these cups down the drain, because it's like they're no bueno. Like, they're no bueno. And it's, you know that they're no bueno, because it seems like you're trying to do like something good for yourself. Like, turn, like I said, those reversals, like turn the winds in your favor, you know, the winds of change. And they're making you feel like fucking shit about it for some reason, because you want to do something good for yourself. And that's not a good friend. That is not a support system. As somebody who cuts you off at the knees is not your support system. And so with this four of pentacles, it's like really having to let that go. And so I'm looking at all of this, and I'm like, I asked, because I like to ask. Is that what came out next? No, let me, I'm getting ahead of myself, I'm sorry. And so then next out you have, after this four of pentacles in reverse, I was like, what do they need to let go? Like, I don't understand. You have the wheel in reverse. And I was like, oh, I'm sorry. It's so weird for me to do the spreads ahead of time. I asked what your ace of pentacles was. I was like, well, if Leo has to let go of all of this stuff and like come out of this little incubation with everything they've done and people are making them feel bad about it, all for this eight of pentacles, I was like, what is the ace of pentacles? And the wheel of fortune came out in reverse. And I was like, the ace of pentacles is a reverse wheel of fortune. I was like, what is that? And I'm like, I'm looking at the card. And I got drawn to the R here. And I was like, R. And obviously it says tear all around the thing, but I'm just like, R. And it looks like a compass. I'm like, right. So I just turned the card right, and it's upright. So I was like, that's what it is. And then it went back to the bad seeds thing. It's like, you guys had planted some bad seeds. And maybe that's part of this push and pull, right? Is these bad seeds trying to like pull you back in. Invest, plant, water. And you're like, no, I'm reaching for more. I know maybe these cups got spilled over in the past, but I know that I can learn from them. There's still some kind of nourishment here that I can integrate in with my experience and allow that to help me grow and plant these new seeds. I can turn this wheel upright. I can do it. And I'm looking, and then next out you have the four of cups, right? And then you have the queen of cups. So again, I'd like to take you on a journey. Come with me, please. Right, so, can you see? Is that all right? Okay, so like I said, ace of pentacles, hermit in reverse, seven of swords, people making you feel guilty, you needing to like let go of that and sit in your truth and your peace, right? The wheel of fortune was in reverse. We can obviously turn it upright. And I'm looking at this and I'm being very drawn to, it's like all of these circles, how it just matches up perfectly. It's like that mirroring. You plant a seed and it could grow or it could also fail. What matters is how you tend to it, how you tend to that flock. Where did you plant it? Was the soil good, right? Did you water it too much? Did you water it too little? Who was taking care of it when you were not there? Right? That is the determination, the energy that you put into things. Both sides, the mirroring, both sides of that energy, what you put in and what you get out, as well as the other party and participants in it. That depends on how your gardens grow. And then I'm looking over here at this four of cups, and she's very much like, and I'm looking at it in conjunction to this hermit in reverse, and I'm almost getting this sense of like, you know, she looks very disgruntled, right? It's like, you know, that this is how you're going to come off to people. You know that this is what you're going to have to deal with. You know what it's going to be like for you to kind of bubble your way up to the surface and really grab this and plant it for yourself. Like, you're going to have to get your hands a little bit dirty. Cancer is kind of doing a little bit of the same thing. But it's almost like not annoyed that you have to do it, but just disappointed because you know it's going to be such a fucking headache. And then you come over here and you're just trying to do your thing. Everybody's making you feel like a thief in the night, screaming at you. And then I see this queen of cups though. It's this like release. It's the relief. It's like hands up, you know, it's like under the spotlight. Everybody's trying to make you feel like a traitor, and you're just like, I surrender. Hands up, arms up. Yes, I'm trying to take this cup. It's my cup. I'm hearing like, I just want what's mine. Like, I surrender, white flag. Like, I just want what's mine. That's it. Like, why are you making me feel that way? Like, I come in peace. I'm really coming to a place of knowing that this thing that you want, this little ace of pentacles you kind of put in your backpack and you're taking with you, you know it's for your highest good. I think that's why you're just like, look at me. Shine the moonlight on me. Shine it on me. Be like, here I am. This is what I'm doing. This is what I'm doing. This is what I want. Look at it if you want. Crow if you want, if you must. If you must. And then I asked, I'm looking at this Four of Pentacles. I was like, okay, so what does Leo need to let go of? Like, what does Leo need to let go of in order to come to this place where they're just like, I surrender. Say what you're gonna say, but like, I need to take this opportunity for myself. And you got out the Five of Wands, Judgment in reverse, and you got Three of Pentacles in reverse. So for me, that tells me that you need to let go of A, the fear that there's going to be conflict, because there probably is going to be. You're probably going to have some of these crows like squawking, like traitor, traitor. It's like they're trying to make you feel like you're abandoning them, or like you're abandoning the group, or it's very much that energy, and I don't like it. It's really yucky. But you're going to have to let go of, because the Five of Wands is not in reverse. So that's telling me that like you need to let go of the fear that there will be conflict, and just know that if something arises, if somebody has a problem with you trying to take new opportunities for yourself after having gone through life and learned your lessons and done what you had to do, then that's their fucking problem. Then they can climb up those wands and they can come get to you and say it to your face. The universe is saying like, it's not like there isn't gonna be conflict. It's not like there isn't gonna be stuff with other people. Absolutely, the Seven of Swords is right here. They're squawking, you know it, they know it. But you can't let that deter you. You can't let that deter you. Judgment in reverse. It's not gonna go well in their favor. It's bad juju for them. But if you engage in it too much, like you don't want to over-engage, don't rile up any fights. If somebody wants to come at you, it's like, that's, I surrender. Like, I have no reason to fight with you. Like, this is what I'm here for. I'm here for what's mine. And I'm entitled to that. That's it. There's Three of Pentacles. And not feeling bad. You have to let go of feeling bad about having to leave some of these people behind. I know that's hard, but it doesn't really seem like they're, like, they care kind of about you anyway. Like, maybe they care about you, but it seems much more like they care about like the group herd mentality than like you in particular. Otherwise they would be able to see how much work I feel like you've done and like what a good opportunity this is for you to start fresh, and they'd be more supportive of you. But they're not. They're making you feel guilty for it, which is why you need to let go of the idea of Three of Pentacles in reverse, of working with these people, of trying to make it work with these people, trying to work it out with your friends or work it out with this job or this person. And you know what? There might be a little conflict, but it's fine. Queen of Cups. Doesn't matter. You're fine. You can handle yourself. You can handle yourself just fine. And then I asked Source. I was like, okay, well, this is why they need to let go of all this stuff for these pentacles. Like, but like, why? Why do they need to let go of all of this stuff in order to obtain this Ace of Pentacles? I could see like why they need to let it go, but why can't they have the Ace of Pentacles without letting this go? Does that make sense? It made sense to them, but it's like, I see that you have to let this go in order to obtain what you want, but why? Like, why can't you obtain what you want without having to go through that? So I asked, and we got out two major arcana. Got out Temperance, and you got out the Hierophant. And then I heard bad seeds again. It's because whatever place this was, whatever people you are or were around, whatever the jig is for you, my dear. Two major arcana about balance, patience, alignment, growth, infrastructure, spirituality, stability. This is a big mama, big daddy. Like, you're never gonna get where you wanna go with these people, with these crows. Every seed you plant in one of these pots, I'm looking back at this girl and I'm almost like, it's like they're trying to hand you this one little pot, like this one little Ace of Pentacles. Like, you can turn this wheel around, here's your little Ace of Pentacles, and you're almost like looking at these little pots like that you planted all these bad seeds in. You're like, I sat here and I planted and I put the soil in and I put the little seed in and I watered it and I let it get the sun and I did everything that I was supposed to do. And you're treating, now I'm trying to do something for myself and you're treating me like this. Like, fuck it, I surrender. Yeah, come for me, come for me. You are never gonna get where you wanted to go with these people in this place. With friends like that, who needs enemies, baby, right? And to let all of this go, to really separate, stop working on shit. Stop trying to make shit work that's not working. Sometimes not everybody's gonna like you, Leo. Not everybody's gonna like you, but you know when you've learned your lessons. You know when you've paid your karmic debts, and you know when it's time for your fresh slate. And it looks like it's now, and you were never gonna get it with them. They were, and it's not just about like getting what you want, like where you want, or the job you want, or the person that you want. It's about like how you wanna be, like how you wanna feel every day when you wake up in the morning. Do you wanna feel good? Do you wanna feel balanced? Do you wanna feel like your head is working with your heart and it's working with your gut? Like your gut instinct, like all like together as one? Or do you want to feel like one's out of control, like your thoughts are all over the place and like your heart's over here and your stomach hurts and you don't know where your, if your ass is up or down? Are you the hangman in reverse? Are you the hangman upright? I don't know. Do you? That's why we're here. These people were screwing you up. They were throwing you off your path. This is about as on path as you can get. Temperance and the Hierophant. And this comes out after you learn to let those people go. Because before you learn to do that, Wheel of Fortune in reverse, which I think tells us everything we need to know. But it's quarantine. Shows you when the, where the real ones are, you know? This is very cool. This is a cool little reading, Leo. Keep strong. Don't let people mess with you. You know what's good for you. Don't let them tell you. Don't let them tell you. They give you trouble, you send them over my way. I'll let them know, okay? Thank you very much for letting me do this for you. This is a cool little read. All of my information should be in the description box if you'd like to be informed. If you want to chit chat, you can comment. Personals are open. You can like and subscribe or just come back. You can just come back. I'm here. You know where I am. You know where to find me. I'll see you later. I'll see you next time, Leo. Thank you.